Hey everyone, how are you doing? This is Lee Gerstmann and I'm going to be doing a record review for you. I have to say, hey buddy, how are you doing? To Johnny Vogan, who, when I asked what album I ought to review, he suggested Guns N' Roses GNR Lies. Well, it had been only relatively recently that I had finished hearing Use Your Illusion, and before that I had specifically heard Appetite for Destruction just so that I could review it. So I'm getting a little bit more familiar with Guns N' Roses. I mean, I've heard their videos and stuff and all of that, and I know of the group, but I never really had any of their albums, and so this is my catching up period. And there were a couple of songs that I had heard off of GNR Lies, but for the most part, it was an album that I thought, well, I could avoid it. It doesn't necessarily seem like it's going to be that great. Well, I have to say overall, it's pretty good. There's a couple of things on here that aren't quite to my taste, but I'll get to them when we get to those songs. Anyway, the first song, Reckless Life, that to me reminded me of the MC5. They rock out to their best ability here, and I really like this song. And then Nice Boys, that to me sounded a little bit like Brownsville Station on speed, and a little bit like The Sweet too. This was another awesome song. And then Move to the City, that sounded like Aerosmith during their Rock and a Hard Place period, but maybe even a little bit better. And then I once made a comment that if Guns N' Roses did a whole Aerosmith album, that would be something I'd be interested in. And I made that comment before I realized that Guns N' Roses did a cover of Aerosmith's Mama Kin, which is one of my favorite songs from Aerosmith. And, well, Guns N' Roses, they do a version that is not quite as good as Aerosmith's original, but still very enjoyable and well done. And then the next song, Patience. Okay, here we go. It took patience for me to hear this. The whistling in the beginning doesn't help much either. It seemed to me like they could have left this off the album. It wasn't my favorite. And then Used to Love Her. Lyrically, this sounds like something I could have written in the early 1980s. It was a fun, silly bar band party song. It was cool. And then You're Crazy. This is pretty good. It shows they can rock pretty hard with acoustic guitars. I thought it was a little bit different than what I'm used to from them, and I enjoyed it. And then the last song, One in a Million. Musically, it sounds like something I could have written back in the early 1980s. But it kind of goes on a little bit long, and I wish the drum could have dropped some heavy beats. So, aside from the controversy with the lyrics, I felt that the way they did it, it ended up being only an okay song. But I would say overall, between Appetite for Destruction and Use Your Illusion and GNR Lies, I would say I would probably go back to GNR Lies if I wanted to continue listening to an album by Guns N' Roses. I thought overall, it was probably their best. So I want to thank you, Johnny, for suggesting this album. I'm glad that I heard it. Well, that's been my review. Okay, take care.